Eliopolous helped his father buy a property in Chelmsford while he was a sitting selectman. As you will learn, Mr. Eliopolous knew that the town was also interested in the same property to expand the nearby fire station or to increase the value of the fire station property itself. However, Mr. Eliopolous did not decline representing his father. You will learn this is the classic conflict of interest prohibited by ethics laws. After the land purchase, Mr. Eliopolous continued to represent his father in securing permits and approvals to build an office building on that same property. You will learn ethics laws also prohibited Mr. Eliopolous from engaging in that conduct as well. You will also learn this privately owned land was protected by a preservation restriction and was intended to be an open space conservation area, a park. The evidence will show that Mr. Eliopolous helped his father build an office building which violated the restriction on the land, which was subject to the restriction. You will see that when Mr. Van Liew discovered what Mr. Eliopolous had done, Mr. Van Liew sharply, repeatedly, and truthfully criticized Mr. Eliopolous' conduct as an elected public official. You learn Mr. Van Liew had nothing to gain personally. This wasn't about money, fame, or greed for Mr. Van Liew. The attacks weren't mean-spirited or personal. Mr. Van Liew spoke in order to protect the land, enforce the laws, and promote good government. Political speech is one of the basic protections granted to us as citizens under the Constitution. Mr. Eliopolous has nevertheless countersued Mr. Van Liew for defamation. Criticisms made about Mr. Eliopolous' actions were not defamatory for reasons that will be made clear to you during the course of this trial. So we ask you, please think about motive as you listen to the evidence in this case. Before we get into the factual landscape of this case, I